Thank you this afternoon, my viewers and my listeners. I thank God for this opportunity that he has given me, and you too, from wherever you are. It's a great day that God has anointed for each and every one of us, that we may be partakers of it, that we may enjoy his blessings, that we may enjoy his goodness, that we may enjoy his blessings, because he is a faithful God. This is yet another day that God has set apart, that we may go to listen to his word, that we may hear his word, that we may partake of his word the way he's going to bring it out to us. This day I'm born of the Lord, blessed of the Lord. My name is John Muli. I'm coming to you live from Beatitude Ministry International, Mombasa Road, Sabaki, Nairobi, Kenya. I request that from wherever you are, that you may follow us, that you may share our teachings, that you may share our preachings, that this teaching and this preaching may reach our brothers and sisters in far wide areas, and that each and every one of us may get to heed and to understand what God wants to hear, what God wants to talk to us this particular time. I'm thankful for our spiritual father, overseer Axon Nongo, for giving me this platform and this opportunity that I may share the word of the Lord. He is our great father, and we honor him from wherever he is. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Our word of today is going to come from the book of 1 Kings, chapter 18, and I'm going to read from verse 37 to verse 40. And this is what the word of the Lord says. Hear me, O Lord, hear me, that these people may know that you are the Lord God, and that you have turned their hearts back to you again. Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt offer sacrifice, and the wood and the stones and the dust, and it licked up the water that was in the trench. Now when all the people saw it, they fell on their faces, and they said, "The Lord, he is God, the Lord, he is God." And Elijah said unto them, "Since the prophets of Baal, do not let one of them escape." So they seized them, and Elijah brought them down to the brook Kishon and executed them all. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Heavenly Father, we are grateful this day. We are humbled before you, O my Father, because of giving us this chance to hear and to heed your word, O my Father. Thank you, King of Glory, for each and every one of us, our viewers and listeners, O dear Lord, from every sphere of their life, King of Glory, and from every corner of this world, dear Lord. I commit them unto you, dear Lord. I surrender them unto you, King of Glory. Loving Father, I speak greatness upon them in the name of the living God. Loving Father, O King of Glory, I speak of your protection upon their life. I speak of your favor upon their life. I speak of your grace upon their life, King of Glory, that each one of them, dear Lord, shall arise and testify that indeed you are God upon their life in the name of the living God. Loving Father, King of Glory, as we share and partake of our word this day, may it bring fruitfulness upon our life, King of Glory. May it bear fruits upon our life, King of Glory. May it transform our lives, dear Lord, my Father, in the name of the living God. I'm speaking this one, my Father, King of Glory, because you have given it unto me, O my Father, for you are people, my call, called by your name, so my Father, in the name of the living God. I commit the body of Christ, O my Father, in all the spheres of the life, King of Glory, and every corner of the world, dear Lord, my Father, that you may cover them, King of Glory, with the precious blood of Jesus, in the name of the living God. Thank you for the grace of salvation, my Father, that you have given each and every one of us, my God. We bless you and we honor you, because you are good unto our life, in the name of the living God. We pray, trusting and believing. Amen. 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 This day, I'm going to share the word of the Lord, the way He is going to give it unto me, and the way He is going to reveal it unto me. I'm sure from wherever we have read, most of us have read these verses more than many times. I know the word has been preached unto us more than necessary times, but I want to bring the same word, the way God intended you to receive it this day, because this was the message that God wanted you to hear, for it to transform your life, for it to change your life, and for it to change your perspective, the way you look at things in your life. Amen. My topic today is very simple, and it is entitled, "The Contest is Over." The contest is over. People of God, I know most of us, and for those who engage in political lives and conversation, there is something we call a contest. And politically, every political lineage or every political scheme is well schemed or planned, and each of them will win or lose depending on how they have marshaled the resources or how they have planned the execution of their political agenda or idea. In a political contest, there's going to be a loser and there's going to be a winner. The winner may not have the necessary resources. The loser may not necessarily be the one who was not prepared. But in one way or the other, it will depend with the favor of God. It will depend with how you connect with God. It will depend with how you relate with God. Because victory comes from God. Leadership comes from God. You may be chosen of people, but you may not be anointed of the Lord. You may be more liked by people, but God may not have chosen you. When you are chosen by people and not anointed by God, you may not necessarily provide the required leadership, even if people give you power to rule them. But when you are anointed by God, when you are called by God to be a leader of a certain situation, to be a leader of a certain group, to be a leader in a certain ministry, no matter how many opposition you are going to face, so long as God is on your side, you are going to emerge the victor, and at the end of it, each of those opponents, they are going to arise and confess indeed you are in good terms with God, and that you serve a living God that has given you victory and favor over that leadership. People of God, from wherever we have read from the book of 1 Kings, chapter 18, from verse number 37 to verse number 40, the Bible brings of a scenario where there was a contest between Elijah and the prophets of Baal and Asherah. Remember this, people of God. When you read the Bible in the before chapters or even the before verses, you are going to get the clear picture of what was happening. But I want to go straight to the point that there was a contest between Elijah and the prophets of Baal and Asherah. Hallelujah. In this case, the Asherahs and Baal were operating under the anointing of King Ahab, and Elijah was operating under the anointing of God. Elijah did not have many prophets. Elijah did not have many people to back him.
Elijah did not have a lot of multitude. Elijah was not dependent on who is going to execute the duty on behalf of him, but he was dependent on God, that he relied on God, that God is going to do it upon his will, that God is going to do it according to his plan, that God is going to deliver victory according to his plan at the appointed time when he wants to magnify himself, when he wants to manifest himself as the God who rules. Hallelujah. But on the other side, King Ahab was depending on the prophets of Baal. King Ahab was depending on the prophets of Asherah. These are two different anointings. Elijah is operating on the anointing of the Most High God. The prophets of Baal are operating the anointing of King Ahab, who is a human being. And as human beings, we are limited. As human beings, our capacity are limited. As human beings, our knowledge are limited. As human beings, our wisdom are limited. As human beings, our resources are limited. But God can never run short of resources. But God can never run short of ideas. But God can never run short of wisdom, because he is the God, the creator. He is God, the sustainer. He is God who provides unto us. Hallelujah. So the contest was on. Elijah called on the prophets of Baal. Elijah called on the contest between him and the prophets of Baal, that they may show their mightiness, that they may show their potential, that they may show their power, they may show their strength. But Elijah for sure knew that so long as I'm with God, so long as God is on my side, so long as I'm dependent on God, no matter what they are going to do, no matter what they are going to execute, no matter what they are going to say, God for sure can never shame himself. God for sure can never fail in this contest. And people of God, many other times when we fail to understand the God that we serve, many other times when we go unto war by ourselves, many other times when we want to execute duties by ourselves, many other times when we put God aside and we want to fight by our own. But I want to tell you something good this day. I want to tell you something good this evening. That any particular time that you are faced with a situation that you can never understand, any time that you come across challenges that you cannot overcome by yourself, any time you are faced with war, any victory you see that you cannot manage it, please, people of God, align yourself in the line of God, and for sure you are not going to be ashamed, because he can never fail, because he can never shame himself. He is so powerful to let you down. He is so faithful to let you down. He is so cool to shame you. The contest is on between Elijah and the prophets of Baal. My Bible says the prophets of Baal, they did their sacrifices, they prayed unto their gods, they beseeched their God, but nothing was happening. Situations were not changing. The sacrifices were not being taken. Nothing was coming through for them. Their God was asleep. Their God was not actioning. Their God was not doing anything. Hallelujah. But I'm happy this evening, because when it came to the time of Elijah, Elijah called upon his call. Elijah exhorted upon his call. Elijah placed upon his call. He has called the God of Israel. He has called the God of Abraham. He has called the God of Isaac. He has called of Jacob. He can never fail. So when Elijah called upon his mighty name, God descended, and he did for sure deliver victory for Elijah. Hallelujah. People of God, I know Baal for sure. They had a lot of multitude. I know Baal for sure. They had a lot of backup. I know Baal for sure. They were waiting for Elijah to be ashamed. And I can actually come and say, if Elijah failed, they could have killed him. I can say for sure, if Elijah did not manifest his call, I'm sure they could have mocked him. If Elijah could not manifest his call, I'm sure they could have frustrated him. I'm sure if Elijah could not betray his God as one was able, I'm sure that day Elijah could have died. But there is a good report to people of God. Even though Elijah was acting in one in person, even though Elijah seemed like he was alone, but there was a God beside him, the God who can never fail. Even though Elijah looked like he can never do anything by himself, God was sitting on the throne and was ready to defend his majesty because he's God. So the Bible says, after the prophets of Baal failed to deliver, after the prophets of Baal failed to do anything, Elijah and his God, the God of Isaac, the God of Abraham, the God of Jacob, the God of whom and you will serve, came down and consumed the sacrifice, and therefore handing over the victory to Elijah. People of God, victory is on our side. Victory belongs to us. We only need to stay put. We only need to stay focused. We only need to stay faithful and worship the God who is able to do abundantly beyond our expectation. I know for sure, from wherever Elijah was, maybe he could not figure how this is going to happen. Maybe he didn't know if God doesn't manifest, what will follow. But God has never failed. God has never failed, child of God. God has never failed my daughter. God has never failed my mother. God has never failed in every situation. He is forever faithful and ready to fight for you, so long as you remain faithful unto him. Hallelujah. In the history of boxing, for most of us who could have been lucky, I know in the early or late 90s, in the boxing circle, there was a boxing fight between a man who was called Paki and another one who was called Evander Holyfield. And the boxing match was very funny. In fact, it was very hilarious. And many people had prepared that at this particular day, we are going to go to the field and we are going to witness this boxing match happen between Paki and Evander Holyfield. But people of God, listen to what happened. After people are very prepared, after people are ready to go and witness the boxing match, the unthinkable happened, that within the 8 seconds that Evander Holyfield was able to box out this man called Pacquiao. Hallelujah. Many of the spectators had taken most of their time. They had mobilized resources, and you know what happens in the matches, that people buy snacks, that people they do savings, that people prepare, because going to be like a celebration. But this one day, it was totally different. When people were ready, and I'm even sure some of them who had come to witness the match, they had not even seated down. By the time they were reaching at the arena, it was announced that Evander Holyfield has knocked down his opponent Pacquiao, and the match was over, and the match was called off, and victory was delivered and handed over to Holyfield. People of God, you may not figure out, you may not understand, you may not have a picture, you may not comprehend how God is going to do it more than sooner. In fact, immediately, soonest that you can imagine, and hand over the victory to you, because you are not going to fight by your might. You are going to fight by your flesh. You are not going to fight by your blood. God is going to fight for you, and He is going to hand over victory. You are going to lift up the trophy of victory and confess of His goodness, because He is going to do it for you, because He is our God. Within no time, because my Bible says, from the morning up to almost the afternoon, the prophets of Baal were marshalling their resources. The prophets of Baal were calling upon their call. The prophets of Asherah, they were praying unto their call, cutting themselves, but nothing was happening. But in within no time, oh my God, listen to this child of God. I want you to comprehend very carefully. I want to hear me clearly, that within no time, oh my God, within the shortest time possible, God delivered victory. God manifested Himself before the prophets of Baal, and Elijah emerged as the victor. Children of God, don't take too much thinking on how you are going to do it. Don't take too much thinking about your enemies. Don't think too much thinking about your opponent. Don't think too much. Don't even stress yourself, because you cannot win this by your own. Don't stress yourself, because you cannot go by your own. Don't kill yourself. Victory will come unto you. God is going to deliver it before you, before your enemies, and they are going to see it by their naked eyes. Hallelujah. So my Bible says, after this happened, after Elijah won the contest, that he ordered all the prophets of Baal and lords of Asherah to be slain, to be slaughtered, to be killed, because they were proven to be pura cabeza. My brother and my sister, many other times when we look upon people, when we rely upon people, when we focus on our resources, when we focus on our ability, when we say that I can be able to do this, my CV is very fat, my CV is very detailed, I am well found in this profession, I can make it, I can do it. But little stand of call, just engage call, put God in the first line. Let God lead you. He is going to do marvelous, and you are going to excel even where you never expected that you can achieve anything. Hallelujah. I want to assure you once more that the contest is over, that the fight is over, that God is going to give them a one-time knockout, and you are going to celebrate, because there will be nobody to oppose your idea. There will be nobody to oppose your family. There will be nobody to oppose what you can give. There will be nobody to oppose your salvation. God is going to give them a one-time knockout, and you'll be the victor in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. People of God, when you look at the Bible, in the book of Exodus, chapter 11, my Bible says that God had planned and could plan to deliver his children from captivity, to deliver his children from the bondage of Egypt, to deliver his children from what they were doing in the land of enslavement. And God is using Moses. Hallelujah. And my Bible says that when Moses spoke unto Pharaoh, and Pharaoh could not release the children of Israel so that they could go unto the promised land, then God decided to manifest himself in many ways that he can. Hallelujah. Children of God, we serve a God that we can never understand. We serve a God who we can never trace his ways. His ways are beyond our understanding. His ways are way above what we can comprehend with our bare minds. And my Bible says that God, after realizing that Pharaoh was not ready to release the children of Israel so that they can go to their promised land, that God decided to bring things where they were called plagues. And several plagues happened in Egypt. And the Bible continued to say, plague after the plague, God hardened the heart of Pharaoh, that Pharaoh could not agree to release the children of Israel. But plague after plague happened, and the heart of Pharaoh was becoming hardened, and therefore he was continuing to misuse the children of God. And therefore Pharaoh continued to molest them. And therefore Pharaoh continued to use them in a bad way. Pharaoh continued to mock the children of God. And the plague happened one after the other. There came the plague of plague. That came and it went. There came the plague of flocks. It came and it went. There came many flocks. than many plagues, but by the ninth plague, which was the plague of darkness, God realized that the heart of Pharaoh was very hard, and he was not ready to let go the children of Israel. People of God, I want you to let you know, you cannot fight the anointed of the Lord. Children of God, I want you to let you know, you cannot fight the chosen of the Lord. People of God, I want to let you know, you cannot stay put. You cannot even hold back the blessed of the Lord, because they are not on their own, but God is on their side. So after the ninth plague, after the contest was going on between Moses and the Pharaoh, Moses standing on the gap of God, and Pharaoh standing on the gap of Egypt, the contest went on. But my Bible say, after the ninth plague, which was the plague of darkness, the worst happened. The final knockout came. The final blow came. The final fight was brought unto end. That after the darkness, God decided, this contest cannot continue. This contest can no longer continue. I cannot continue anymore with this contest. And I have to bring it into a stand. I have to bring it unto end. I have to finish everything. I have to do with it once and for all. So after the ninth plague, after the plague of darkness, which the Bible says that the dark was so much that you could even feel it, that the dark was so much that you could even touch it, but Pharaoh was still hardened in his heart. Oh my God. But God was not done yet. But God was not done yet. God had not lost the contest. God had not lost the war. God had decided that Pharaoh, you must let go, my children. That Pharaoh, you must let go, my blessed. That Pharaoh, you must let go, those whom I have called. That Pharaoh, you must let go, those whom I have saved. Because they are called by my name. They are children of Israel, the blessed of the Lord, the anointed of the Most High God. So God decided that I am going to bring this contest. I'm going to bring this contest into an end once and for all. And it shall never again appear in the mind of Pharaoh that he can hold my people back. It can never happen again in the mind of Pharaoh that he can continue forever frustrating and molesting my people. So children of God, God instructed Moses that go to my people and tell them they need to slaughter a lamb and they need to smear the blood in the doorpost, that when my angel come, or even when I come in the representation of an angel, when I see the blood in the doorpost of my people, I will pass over to the next household. If they don't have a blood, if they are to a post, I'm going to kill the firstborn, the male of their family. And Pharaoh, we have to let you go because you have no choice. This is going to be the last blow of his contest. People of God, the worst happened in the land of Egypt. Their firstborn died. They lost their resources. They had lost their livestock. They had lost so many things. But because of the hardness of the heart of Pharaoh, they had to lose. But God could never lose that war. But God could never lose that contest. He had to deliver victory unto his people. My brothers and sisters, we are co-heirs of the blessing of Abraham. We are called by the name of the Most High God. We are saved by his blood. We are redeemed by his blood. God is calling you that you can no longer continue going through what you are going through. God is calling you that you have to do with that contest. God is calling you. You must secure the victory because he is doing it for you. God is going to call you because you are called by his name. You are going to emerge the victor because the victory is going to come from him, not from you. You are enemies, you are contestants. Anybody who is fighting with you will just get surprised, because at the end of it, they are going to lose this war. Just stay put, focus on God, trust on him, give home of him, just praise him. He is faithful, he can never fail you. He is faithful, he can never let you down. He is faithful. He can never shame you. You are going to win the contest. Victory is yours. Hallelujah. In all these things, if only Pharaoh could understand the God he is dealing with, if only Pharaoh could comprehend what is going to come of him, if only Pharaoh could understand what will befall him at the end of contest, he would have led the children of God to go unto the promised land. But the tricky part of it is this: the people of God, Satan is very cunning. The devil is very cunning. The devil appears to be very sly. And he always convinces people that don't fear, you are going to defeat this one. Don't fear, his God is not powerful. Don't fear, you are going to emerge the victor. Don't fear. But if only they can understand that the devil is a liar, that the devil is a murderer, that the devil is a sly, that he only gives lies, that whatever is telling unto them to engage war with you, the blessed of the Lord, the anointed of the Lord, if only they can understand, the earlier the better, that they cannot win war with you, the better they surrender early enough and hand over victory in peace. I'm calling you this evening, my brother and sister, that don't tire, don't feel exhausted, don't lose hope, don't lose focus, don't lose your faith. Just stay focused, stay put, trust in the Lord. He is going to give you victory. Where devil imagine that he can remove you from the ring, you are going just to give him one time knockout and he will never appear again. You are going to give him one time knockout that he will never think of contesting again against you. By the time we were starting this period of Corona, I know most of us were feeling like now it's the end of the world. I know most of us were feeling that I'm going to die of this disease. I'm going to lose it unto this disease. I'm going to leave behind my family. I'm going to lose my business. I'm going to lose my life. But I want you to understand, people of God, we can never win this war unless God is fighting for us. We can never win this war unless God is fighting for us. That's why I'm calling upon the church. We must stand on the car. We must stand again. We must praise our God. We must call our God. We must pray like never before. We must praise like never before. We must have faith like never before. Because God, no matter what, He is going to deliver victory unto us. We are going, all of us, to emerge and to say, despite the situation be hard, despite the pandemic, we have called all of us. We have called all of us. We have numbered each and every one of us. None of us is missing. We are all available. We are all in numbers. God has delivered from this pandemic that was supposed to wipe us away. He is faithful. He is faithful. He is faithful. Children of God, my Bible says in the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 17, when you read downwards, you are going to get a picture and a story where there was a contest between the anointed of God, who was David, and the Philistines, who were being represented by a man called Goliath. Hallelujah. The contest was on. Philistine had their representative. They were calling him Goliath. And the children of God, they had their representative. In fact, who was very minor, a junior one, a young man. He was called David. And the Bible says, by the look by your naked eyes, if anybody looked by their eyes, they could see that David was going to lose the war. Anybody who looked around, they could see that David cannot win this contest. Anybody who was around couldn't understand that David was engaging in a futile war where he cannot win, because against him was standing a Philistine by the name Goliath, who was big in his stature, who was very big in his size. By the look of the naked eyes, nobody could understand how David is going to fight with Goliath. But children of God, for most of us who have read the Bible more than many times, who have read the Bible and understood the story, they cannot test for the goodness of the Lord. That before even the end of the contest, that Goliath was no more, that David had won the war, that David emerged the victor on behalf of the children of Israel. My people of God, my brothers and sisters, it might appear that the situation behind you, the situation ahead of you, the situation left, right, and center looks like a mountain unto you. You don't know where to start. You don't know where to end. But then remember, amidst all that, engage the most powerful call. Engage the supernatural call. Engage the most powerful call. He is going to make the way straight. He is going to remove the crookedness of the ways. He is going to break the doors before you. He is going to break the iron gate before you. You are going to have victory. He is good. He is faithful. He can never lose as long as you trust upon him. My brothers and sisters, I know for sure we can never exhaust the many examples that we have been given in the Bible where God never lost in any contest. And that's why I'm coming unto you this evening to tell you, so long as you're in good relationship with God, so long as you are in line with God, so long as you are trusting upon God, so long as you are faithful upon God, never again cry, never again relent, never again lose hope, never again be frustrated. God is going to do something good upon your life. He is going to give you a new testimony. He is going to clothe you with dominion. He is going to clothe you with glory. He is going to cover you with favor. He is going to give you a victory. You are going to be the victor where everybody else who was against you expected you to lose. But so long as you are standing with God, you are going to be the one that people shall arise. Indeed, he serves a living God. My brothers and sisters, my Bible says, hallelujah, in Luke chapter 12, when you read the book of Luke chapter 12, downwards, and when you reach to verse 11, the Bible says, when you are taken before the rulers, when you are taken before the judges, when you are taken before your enemy, never worry what you are going to say. Never worry what you are going to tell them. Never worry what you are going to say. Because God is going to tell you what you are going to say before them. Because God is going to give you words. Because God is going to give you testimony. Because God is going to give you a word. Because God will speak on your behalf. So my brothers and sisters, never shy away because things are not working. Never shy away because it has taken long. Never shy away because you feel like a failure. Never shy away because you feel like people are against you. There lives a living God. There is a living God. He lives high above in the sky. He sits on the throne. He can never be overthrown. That is God that you are supposed to look upon. That is the God that you are supposed to rely on. That is the God that you are supposed to have faith on. He is going to give you victory. And he is not only going to give you victory, he is going to issue a one-time knockout that will be declared the winner of the contest, even between or amidst the misunderstanding that could be in that situation. Heavenly Father, in the name of the living God, Thank you for your word. Thank you for your people. Thank you for this day. Thank you for your anointed working of glory. Thank you for those who are called by your name. Thank you because you are cool. I see my Father. I honor you this day. I glorify you, King of Glory. I magnify you, my dear Lord. I exalt you, my Father, because above everything, you can never lose the contest. I declare to your people that this is a blessed day. They are going to see your hand. They are going to see your victory. They are going to see your name appearing before you, before them. They are going to testify upon your mighty name. Even their neighbors looking of glory. They are evil, my Father. Even their enemies, King of Glory, they shall surely arise and confess and say, indeed he serves the living God, in such is blessed of the Lord, because my Father, King of Glory, you are going to do beyond our means. You are going to do beyond our ability in the name of the living God. And upon this altar this day, I declare to your people that they shall live long, that they shall have good health, that they shall enjoy your goodness, that they shall enjoy your redemption, that they shall enjoy your victory. In the name of the living God, they shall arise at the end of it and confess indeed, you are a good God, because sickness is not going to kill them, because pandemic will not wipe them away, because hunger will not take them away. In the name of the living God, at the end of it, dear Lord, we are going to count them, and all of them, dear Lord, will be blessed, confessing of your goodness, praising you, dear Lord, and celebrating you, because you are dear Lord and you are cool. In the name of the living God, I pray, trusting and believing. Shalom, 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 child of God. I'm sure this word has come to you the way God expected you to receive it. How I pray and trust that upon receiving this word, that you are going to share it with your brothers, you are going to share it with your sisters, you are going to share it with your neighbors, and they are going to be partaker of this word that God has given unto us, unless they are going to be assured that they cannot win, they cannot lose the contest, because the contest is over. Shalom, shalom, shalom. Stay blessed, stay blessed, stay blessed. Amen.